Hi, it's Janie. Welcome back to my channel. And today I have a few of my favorite things that I thought I would share with you. These are products that I have been using that I enjoy and that I like and I think are worth mentioning and doing a video on them. So let's get started. The first thing I want to talk about is an item that was sent to me through Optily, and this is from the company 100% Pure. If you watch those haul videos, my PR haul videos, you know I've been getting a lot of products sent to me from this line. And I really, honestly and truly do enjoy the 100% Pure line. They are an all-natural, organic, vegan, cruelty-free brand that use natural ingredients, fruit pigments, that type of thing, in their products. And this is the Blood Orange Cleansing Balm, and it has in here a lot of like avocado oil, coconut oils, there's a whole list of oils. Let me put my glasses on so we can see. Organic avocado oil, coconut oil, organic olive oil, organic beeswax, blood orange essential oil, and I think that's all the oils that it has in it, but it's very natural, and it's just a cleansing balm, just like any that you would get from like Clinique or Colleen Rothschild or any of those that maybe you have tried. But it looks like this here. It just is a balm that you just dip your fingers in. It's a solid, but once you dip your fingers in it, then you rub it around, and the heat from your fingers emulsify it, and then you just rub it and massage it onto the skin, and it just takes all of that makeup away and doesn't leave any trace of makeup. And what I like about it, with all those different oils in there, I do have dry skin, this will leave your skin very, very soft and supple. It doesn't leave your skin dry or tight feeling, so I really do enjoy it for that. Plus, the smell of it smells so good, just like oranges. Oh, it smells so good. But yes, and I have been enjoying this and been using it. I don't think I have anything negative to say about it. I guess the only thing would be, you know, you have to dip your finger in it, but any cleansing balms are going to be that way. It does run $38, which is probably about the same pricing as what Clinique and Colleen Rothschild and some of those run. But yeah, I do like it. I'm enjoying it. I think this is be really, really good in the winter time when my skin is really dry, extremely dry. But I have definitely been enjoying it now, because I've been using another product that I'm going to talk about that is creating some really, 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 really dry skin for me. But there's a reason why. Anyway, so I have been enjoying that. And like I said, it was $38, and there will be a link in the description box for that product if you're interested in it. Okay, and the next product I'm going to talk about is from First Aid Beauty, and it's the First Aid Beauty Facial Radiance Intensive Peel. I had just a deluxe size sample of it, so I'll see if we can get a close-up of it. But it does come in a tub. It doesn't come in a squeezy tube like this, but I did cut it so I could get every last drop out of it. But it's a clay-based product, and it is a peel. You put it on clean, dry skin, and you leave it on there for about 3 to 5 minutes, and then, or until it dries, basically, and then you rinse it off. And your face will feel very smooth and soft, but that's not where the magic comes in. Probably, I would say, within 24 hours to maybe 36 hours of using that, you will start noticing peeling going on your face. And hopefully, if everything goes accordingly, there'll be a side-by-side here that's going to kind of show you a close-up of my face and how it's peeling. I don't think here you're going to be able to see, but I have a lot of peeling right in here around my nose, up in here. And I must have gotten some up in here, because I have some peeling up here around my eyes. I don't I don't recommend or tell you at all to put it up in this area. I just must have had some here and somehow had some residue on my finger and got it up there, because my allergies have been horrible here lately, and I'm always got my finger stuck in my eye. But yes, this, you can get this at Sephora. Does Ulta carry Fresh Day Beauty? I don't know. But anyway, it runs around $40. You use it for about 2 times a week. You will get a slight stinging or tingling sensation, but it's not unbearable at all. But if you feel that it is, then rinse it immediately. Do not wait for it to dry. But within 24 hours, 36 hours, you will start getting some really good peeling going on. And then what I do once it starts to peel, then I'll use my Clarisonic and just kind of buff all that dead skin off, or a manual exfoliating product, and take all that off, and then you just have really smooth baby skin underneath. So I do recommend it. It's not abrasive. It is a chemical exfoliant. It's not a physical exfoliant. You might want to do a patch test on it though, because it does work. The only place that I really don't notice any peeling for me is my cheeks. I hardly ever get anything that peels on this part right here. But I'll get peeling up here on my forehead, down here, around the nose, on the nose, anyway. But yeah, so that's how this stuff comes in handy, because it's so moisturizing that just, I need lots of moisture when I start really peeling. And plus, you know, moisture will help soften that dead skin and it's easier to get off. But it has in there some lactic acid, salicylic acid, and actizyme, I think I'm saying that right, but it's what the key ingredients are in there that causes the exfoliation process, the peeling process to happen. So I do recommend that. You might be able to go into Sephora and get a sample of it to try it before you actually buy it, just to see how your face reacts to that. But it is a really good chemical peel. The next product I want to talk about is from By Terry, and it is a lip balm. It is the Balm de Rose lip balm, which is very much a very luxury high-end product. I don't know if I'm going to get a good focus on that or not. Let me pull it back, maybe. Anyway, it is $60. But it's I think it's worth it. Your lips are very important to take care of, and a lot of times we forget to take care of our lips until they are in dire need of some tender loving care, because they're chapped, they're dry, they're irritated. But if you use a lip balm and get on the front side of it and start and being proactive instead of preactive, is that what I want to say? Anyway, you know what I'm saying. You want to keep it moist and tend to your lips before they get to that point where they are screaming for help and for attention. So I really do like this. One, for one, it smells like roses, which I love anything that smells like roses pretty much. And I just put it on at night right before I go to bed. It's the last thing that I do before I turn off my light to go to sleep, and it just moisturizes all night long. I can still feel a little bit of it in the morning time. I put it all on the lips. I also put it all around my lips, kind of like a little girl would put lipstick on. You know how we would go all the way around? That's what I do. I just slather it on over there, because it has some really good skincare ingredients in it that's really good for the area around the lips and for the lip itself. It has some essential rose, a rose wax in it that is good for smoothing or soothing the lips. It has some essential floral oils in it that are for nourishing and moisturizing. And then it has some ceramides in it that help to smooth the skin on the lips and around the lips. That's why I like to really put it around the lips also, because it has some really good skincare ingredients in there that helps to repair and maintain the moisture around your lips. So I do recommend it. It has vitamin E in it, which is your antioxidants. So yes, even though it is pricey, it doesn't take a whole lot of this. So a little bit goes a long way. So I think that $60 price tag, if you look at it by, anyway, I do recommend it, even though it is pricey. I do think you will get your money's worth out of it though. The next product I want to talk about is from Smashbox, and it looks like this here. It is the Smashbox Under Eye Hydrating Primer. And basically, it is a primer that you put on underneath the eyes to prep this area here before you put concealer on. And what I like about this is that it really helps to smooth underneath the eyes. I have a really hard time with concealers creasing and cracking up underneath my eyes because I do have aging eyes. I do have a lot of fine lines underneath my eyes from years of laying out in the sun without sunglasses or any kind of sun protection. So I was squinting a lot. So now I have the damage from doing that, and I have a lot of fine lines under here. So anytime I can find a product that I think helps that concealer to go on and for it to go on smoothly and to help the concealer not crack and crease as much, then I'm all for it. This is around $29. You can get this at Ulta, at Sephora, and of course off the Smashbox website. It does have some anti-aging ingredients. So with time, it's going to help with puffiness because it has caffeine in it. It has peptides and it has optical diffusers in it also. It's going to help to brighten underneath the eye also. And I will do it. It does have a little tip on here where you could just apply it like this if you wanted to. I don't do that. I just put a little bit on my finger and then I just kind of blend it and tap it on underneath there. And then I let it kind of sit for just a minute and then I put my concealer on. But this is what it looks like there. Has a little bit of a pink tint to it, but once you spread it out, it doesn't really have a tint to it at all. But it is right there. See how it just has those diffusers in there that kind of helps to brighten underneath the eye? So I really do like that. I'm enjoying it. I'm almost done with this tube also. And this is one of those products that I've had for quite some time. And when I first got it, I didn't like it. So I just tossed it in the drawer. Haven't used it, but I'm on a mission to kind of start using up a lot of products. And since I've been on this huge no buy, I'm really rediscovering products in my collection that I didn't think I liked, but I'm giving them more than just a one use shot, so to speak, and giving them a chance to work for me. And I found that I really do like this. So we'll be putting that on my Sephora wish list for the next VIB sale. The last thing I want to talk about are these metal palettes that you can order from Sephora. You can also get them from the Makeup Forever website. I also know that Nigel's carry them also, and you can order from them. They're just really hard to get your hands on them because they're always sold out, especially on the Sephora website. But they're anywhere from $10 to $14, depending upon the size. There's four different sizes that you can order, and I like them a lot better than the Z palettes just because they're sturdier. So I feel like if you're going to be traveling with these, it's going to protect your eyeshadows or blushes, whatever you have in here, a whole lot better than what the Z palette would. Also think they're going to hold up better than the Z palette. But I have my Makeup Forever eyeshadows in here. In this one, it is a magnetic or a metal magnetic base, so your eyeshadows or whatever are just going to stick there. It does have a mirror. Well, no, it doesn't. That's just the reflection from the metal container. It doesn't have a mirror. And I have a small one here that would hold probably like four shadows that I'm going to be putting some Makeup Geek shadows in there. I have the extra large one also. And in this one, I have, what do I have in this one? Oh, this one I have my Makeup Atelier eyeshadows that I depotted and put in there. So you can see how much. This one I think is the extra large one. You can see how many shadows fit in there. And those are the same size as MAC and Makeup Geek eyeshadow singles. And I have another one here. They all come with a foam protectant that you can put over the top if you want. And in this one I have some of my MAC loose shadows there. But yes, very much impressed with them. I like them. Like I said, I feel like they're sturdier than anything that you can get from the Z palettes as far as the way they're made. The only downside to them is you can't see what's in them, but you can always take here and put like a white paint pen and write on here what's in here, say MAC eyeshadows or Makeup Geek or whatever it is that you have in there. That way you would know without having to open it each time. But yes, so anyway, that, my friends, is my favorites. I hope that you enjoyed and will be so kind to give a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed, please subscribe. Click on the little bell icon for future videos, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.